Tallgrass Prairie, and joining me today is the Pollinator Outreach Coordinator, Stephanie Jordan. Stephanie, thanks so much for joining us out here.
Good to see you.
So one of the things the Tallgrass Prairie is known for is the biodiversity.
Right.
How critical is that for our pollinators?
It's so important for our pollinators. There is a huge variety of native flowering pollinator plants out here, but there are particularly crucial plants out here that the monarch butterfly needs. And as most of your viewers are aware of probably, the monarch butterflies come through Oklahoma in the spring and then they come back through in the fall.
Yeah.
We'll start seeing them in late September, early October. But the spring migrators are the ones that we really like to think about in terms of milkweed. The monarchs that go down to Mexico and overwinter are not reproducing. But as the day length gets a little bit longer and the temperatures increase, they start getting the signal to become fully mature and start making baby monarchs. And so they do that as they're starting to migrate north. The monarchs start laying eggs around mid-Texas and lay eggs all the way up until a little bit north of here in Kansas. And so it's crucial that they're able to find milkweed to lay their eggs on. And so at Tallgrass Prairie, we have many, many varieties of milkweed. This one is common milkweed. Mm-hmm. It's a really fun milkweed. It's got big funky pods.
I was going to say, it's done blooming now,
yeah.
But those pods that it has on there is just so impressive.
Those pods, yeah. And then when they turn brown and crack, those seeds are ready to harvest. So when those spring monarchs are coming through here, they can find their native their larval host plant and make their babies. And you can imagine when that first generation is really successful and can find a whole lot of milkweed, then we're going to have a bigger overwintering population going back down the next fall. And so it's really great that we have this 62 contiguous square miles of native pollinator plants and milkweed. But what my job is,
uh-huh,
is to encourage people to create their own little pocket prairie pollinator garden at home to get them to serve them along the way.
Right. So we don't all have this landmass.
We don't all have 62 square miles, but if you have 6x2
right
feet of garden, then you can plant a diversity of plants that'll support all the pollinators, and hopefully you could get some milkweed in there too. All of this is naturally occurring. None mm-hmm. of this has been seeded. And so a lot of their naturally occurring milkweed has gone away due to loss of habitat and development, but the biggest chunk of it has been because of Roundup Ready crops. This kind of milkweed used to really be an issue for farmers, but when all that milkweed went away, then we have to step up and help them out and support
right.
them.
So Stephanie, I know you're not fighting this fight alone, so you're also partnered with Okies for Monarchs, is that correct?
That's correct. The Nature Conservancy of Oklahoma is a big supporter of Okies for Monarchs, and I work together with a big team of people there to get information out about planting native pollinator plants. And you can go to the website at okiesformonarchs.org, and there are tons and tons of resources.
Okay.
But other pollinators come to the milkweed, too. Different milkweed functions a little bit differently, and this one is very, very popular with the monarch caterpillars.
Mm-hmm.
But one of the more common milkweeds that we find is butterfly milkweed,
mm-hmm.
and that one is not as popular for laying larvae on, but it makes a crown of a whole bunch of flowers.
Okay.
And so that's a really important nectaring plant in the fall. And in the fall, when we have the fall migration, we like to think about they need food.
Mm-hmm.
They don't need so much nursery, but they need food.
We're trying to get them back to Mexico.
We're trying to get them back to Mexico, so we want to fuel them up. And so when your butterfly milkweed, when it stops blooming, it's going to put on a pretty little pod, and you can wait for that pod to turn brown and pop, and then you can save those seeds and put them down before winter comes. They need to feel a little bit of winter so that they get certain cues going in the seed.
So not only good for pollinators, but also just your garden interest.
It is good for your garden interest, but what I found is that, you know, psychologically, when you start bringing all of this beauty into your life,
uh-huh,
it's really good for you psychologically.
Yeah.
Not everybody has the time to come to this beautiful preserve. And so if you can make just a little pocket preserve at your own house,
yeah,
that's really great. And we need an army of people to support
and
all of our pollinators.
And connecting those backyards all the way to Canada,
that's right? That's right.
Awesome.
Yeah, we have our bison stay here, but the monarchs are in motion. And
yeah,
so they need lots and lots of pit stops along the way.
All right, Stephanie. Thank you so much for this information.
Thanks a lot.
We hope you enjoyed this video as part of our Oklahoma Gardening YouTube channel. You can also find even more videos on the OK Gardening Classics YouTube channel. And join us on social media for great gardening tips, photos, and discussion.